Hi there, it's Jenny from Quick Anime Recap, and today we are continuing the part 2 of Higehiro. So sit tight and enjoy the video. The anime continues with Goto-san going to Yoshida's apartment to meet Sayu, and meanwhile Yoshida explains the situation to her. Upon reaching the apartment, Goto-san introduces herself and offers Sayu some snacks. As the truth about Sayu's relationship to Yoshida is told to Goto-san, the room enters an awkward silence. Feeling the tension behind the silence, Yoshida leaves the room to use the bathroom, and Goto-san proposes that she talk alone with Sayu. So, Sayu tells him to go to the convenience store to pick up some ingredients. After he left, Goto-san asks Sayu some question about her backstory, and then asks the important question. Meanwhile, Yoshida runs into Mishima in the streets. After learning that he is going to the store, Mishima tag along. Back to Sayu, she gives no answer to Goto-san's question. But she elaborates how she had survived in the past 6 months, until she met Yoshida, who promised to help her. Hearing this, Goto-san states she's happy that Sayu has found a safe haven. Reflecting on her past actions, Sayu acknowledges that she cannot run away forever, and that one day she will have to confront her past. Goto-san then embraces Sayu, and praises her for her courage. Returning to Yoshida, he tries to part ways with Mishima, but she asks if she can stay at his place tonight. Yoshida flatly refuses, which leads into a minor argument between the two, and Mishima calls out Yoshida for having Goto-san over his apartment. This revealed she has been stalking him. In light of that, Mishima apologizes for stalking, but Yoshida thinks nothing of it. Sitting outside the store, Mishima questions if he truly loves Goto-san, or he had fallen in love with Sayu. Yoshida denies that fact, saying he is merely looking after Sayu, but Mishima then calls out Yoshida for being far too nice. She then apologized for causing a scene and left. Finally able to return home, Yoshida sees Goto-san applying makeup onto Sayu's face. He then gives a sheepish compliment. Playfully, Goto-san and Sayu then criticize Yoshida for his half-hearted compliment. Later, Yoshida walks with Goto-san and the two talk about Sayu. Before separating, Goto-san warns him that Sayu is unstable and will one day unleash her emotions onto Yoshida. However, Goto-san is confident that Yoshida will handle the situation well. Elsewhere, at the store, Asami talks with a co-worker, Kyuka, and he apparently knows Sayu. The next day, Sayu arrives at work, and Kyuya enters the scene and introduces himself. The two then instantly recognize one another. As it turns out, Sayu had stayed at his house before. But just as Sayu tries to deny she have ever met him, Asami enters. Recognizing the situation, she kicks him out and comforts Sayu. After work, Sayu walks home, she runs into Kyuya. He strikes up a conversation with Sayu. But she once again denies ever knowing him and tries to evade him. Suddenly, he grabs Sayu's arm and demands that he come over to her house. He blackmails Sayu that he will tell Asami about their past actions together. Disconcerted by this threat, Sayu let him come to her apartment, and she notifies Yoshida via text message about the situation. At Yoshida's apartment, Kyuya asks about their true interactions with each other, which Sayu answers that they didn't done such a thing together. Surprised by the revelation, Kyuya then tries to manhandle Sayu, and during this, Sayu smacks him. Agitated, Kyuya gets on top of Sayu. Just then, Yoshida appears. And after questioning Sayu about her relationship to Kyuya, he kicks him out. Yoshida then interrogates Kyuya, who reveals that a few months ago, Sayu stayed at his house. After a brief argument, Yoshida tells him to stay away from Sayu, which he promised Yoshida and left. Returning to his apartment, Yoshida and Sayu have a heart-to-heart with each other about Sayu's past and well-being. Tearfully, Sayu thanks Yoshida. The following day, Asami notices Sayu looking gloomy, and asks her if something had occurred involving Kyuya. Sayu didn't answer her, which Asami approaches Kyuya in the break room and asks him if he did anything to Sayu the day before. Going along with the scenario, Kyuya admits that he did. So, Asami smacks Kyuya in the face and demands that he apologize to Sayu. Kyuya gives a half-hearted apology to Sayu, who asks him why he didn't reveal their past to Asami, so he recites his promise not to do that since she let him in her apartment. Hearing this confuses her, and she admits that if Kyuya ever do it again, she will be mad. After work, Sayu is notified by Yoshida that he will be staying late at work. So Asami requests to stay over her house, and Yoshida allows it. They then stop by her parents' house to pick up some things. Asami reveals that her father is a politician and her mother is a lawyer. The two then walk to their destination, and as they do, Saya reveals her backstory to Asami. By nightfall, the two reach a perfect spot for stargazing. There, Asami reveals her dream to become an author, which Saya happily supports her. They then had a heart-to-heart with each other, and Asami then tries to console and motivate Sayu, who tearfully hugs her. The following day, Yoshida arrives home early from work and brings home some food. He also apologizes for not able to protect her. But Sayu argues that he did. She explains that because of him, she's able to think about her future. In light of that, Yoshida promises to help Sayu to achieve her goal. Elated, Sayu hugs Yoshida and welcomes him home. At the store, Sayu and Asami talk about what to do during this summer break. They then see a black car pulls up by the store for a brief moment and drives away. Asami notes the car comes here all the time. After that, Sayu helps Asami study literature at her apartment, which Sayu contemplates about her future, until Asami interrupts her. Meanwhile, Yoshida receives a text from Sayu, and Mishima watches in envy. Just then, Goto-san approaches Yoshida and asks him some questions. Once they separate, Mishima confronts Goto-san at her desk and asks to have lunch with her. Soon afterward, in the cafeteria, Mishima questions Goto-san about what she thinks of Yoshida. Goto-san honestly answers her thoughts, which Mishima is informed that Goto-san also knows about Saya living in Yoshida's apartment. She then have an argument with her, saying Goto-san should do something about Sayu if she truly loves Yoshida. However, Goto-san explains that forcing someone into a relationship will never work, and is best to just let it happen naturally. Put off by her answer, Mishima calms down. After work, Mishima approaches Yoshida and asks him for his contact information, which Yoshida reluctantly agrees, asking why she wants his phone number. To that, Mishima confesses, breaking the awkward silence. Mishima sends Yoshida a text asking him out to see a movie sometime. In response to the text, Yoshida sends a text saying, sure. Amused by Yoshida's response, she notes how childish he can be, but this is why she likes him. Later at Yoshida's apartment, he enjoys a special dinner that Sai prepared. The following day, Sai does her daily chores around the house and Yoshida decides to help out. However, Sai drags Yoshida onto his bed and claims that the chores around the house are her job. This causes the two to fall onto each other. Yoshida then went to take a shower. During Yoshida's shower, Saya finds a box in his closet, and inside, Saya finds a picture of a young Yoshida with a beautiful girl. Yoshida then explains he was in a relationship with her in high school, and he said that he spent a lot of time with her back then. At the store, the car stops by the store again. Sayu is shocked when she saw the passenger exits the car. Seeing this, Kiya hides Sayu in the staff room. The passenger then enters the store and introduces himself, revealing he is Sayu's brother, Isa. Kyuya then brushes off Isa, saying Sayu did not work here, and he had made a mistake. After he left, Kyuya enters the back room and tells Sayu that his brother had left, but warns her that he will come again. Sayu realizes this, however, she thinks that now is not the time. While go on a shopping trip, Sayu bumps into Mishima, and they start to talk. Just then, Saya spots her brother and hides behind Mishima in a panic. After being told about Saya's situation, Mishima takes Sayu to a karaoke bar, and they enjoy some drinks together. Sayu then texts Yoshida about her situation. Meanwhile, Yoshida finally finishes his work and is perplexed by the text that he gets from Sayu that she's with Mishima. After they finishes their karaoke session, Sayu and Mishima have a heart-to-heart about the people chasing after Sayu, which Mishima states she doesn't have much time left. Sayu understands this. However, she's still not ready to go home yet. So Mishima then advises Sayu that she should seriously consider what she wants to do now. At that moment, Yoshida arrives and takes Sayu home. He extends an invitation to Mishima to join them, however, she declines. Before leaving, Yoshida promises to take Mishima out for a movie to repay her. Once Yoshida is gone, Mishima has a tearful meltdown, saying how Yoshida does not reciprocate her love for him. While walking home, they spot a poster for the summer festival that's set to start the following day. After talking it over with Sayu, they decided to go together. The following night, the two head to the summer festival. Sayu notices that Yoshida is hesitant to look at her. So Sayu asks Yoshida how she's looking. He replies, she looks pretty, making Sayu blushes. While Sayu enjoys the cotton candy, she shares some with him. Just then, a young boy bumps into Sayu and Yoshida grabs her arm, preventing her from falling. Although hesitant to hold Sayu's hand, she insists they continue so they don't get lost. Soon after, they watch the fireworks and Yoshida contemplates that he'd never gone to the festival before. He then reflects on his life at his apartment without Sayu, but when he snaps out of it, he realizes that Sayu is gone. After calling for her, Sayu appears claiming she was just throwing away some trash. They then continue watching the firework. Yoshida then asks if Sayu plans on returning home, but he retracts it when Sayu asks him what he meant by that. Once the fireworks are finished, Yoshida and Sayu return home together. The following day, Sayu's older brother Isa makes an appearance at Yoshida's apartment, claiming he's there to take Sayu home. Thanks for watching the video. Still want to watch more anime recap? Click the videos on the screen to watch more. And don't forget to subscribe to catch the latest upload. Bye!